献上我的心给你，献上我所有为你，只愿讨你喜悦，明白你旨意，哦主。献上我的心给你，献上我所有为你，只愿讨你喜悦，明白你旨意。
今天我的题目是母亲节快乐，为什么母亲节快乐？
So today my message is Happy Mother's Day. Why aren't mothers happy on Mother's Day?
母亲 会怎么样最后她会觉得快乐？
Like what makes a mother happy?
我觉得一个母亲如果她的小孩照着神的计划都成全了，她成为最快乐的母亲。
I believe that when a mother sees God's plan fulfilled on her sons or daughters, that's what makes a mother the most happy.
每一个小孩在生下来的时候，妈妈、爸爸都有期待，对不对？
Every child who is born to this world, our fathers and mothers have expectations for them.
你知道吗？我们每一个人生到这个世界上的时候，上帝都有一个计划。
So don't you know that everyone who came to this earth has a plan from God?
没有人是多余的。
No one is an extra.
来跟旁边说一下，你不是多余的。
Say the person next to you, you are not an extra.
你来这个世界，神有计划的。
God has a plan for you in this world.
Amen. 这个非常重要。
This is very important.
你不是不小心来这个世界。
It is not an accident that you came.
你来这个世界不是意外，
you are not an accident.
是神的恩典。
You are the grace from God.
Amen. Amen. 那如果妈妈知道神在你生命的计划是什么？
So if a mother knows God's plan for you,
而且看见百分之百上帝的计划在你身上成全了，
and you see 100% of God's plan fulfilled on you,
我相信她要成为最喜乐的母亲。
I believe she will be the most happy, the happiest mom in this world.
上个礼拜我们讲到，如果有人一生可以活70岁的话。
Last week we mentioned that if a person lives to 70.
有人做一个统计数字。
Someone did the statistics.
1/320年睡着了。
1/3 20 years are used from sleeping.
另外1/3工作用掉了。
Another 20 years working.
吃饭的时候花了6年在吃饭，
6 years eating.
7年的时间在看电视在玩乐，
7 years on entertainment.
5年的时间在穿衣服看哪件比较漂亮，穿上来脱下去，
5 years you are trying on different dresses and see what looks the best and bathing.
活70岁的时候居然有1年在打电话，
and you actually spend 1 year on the telephone.
如果你是抽烟的话，你2年在抽烟，
if you're a smoker you spend 2 years smoking.
3年的时间在等人家买衣服，等人家上车，等人家上厕所。
Three years you're waiting for someone, you're waiting in line to go somewhere or get something.
另外3年你可能做你想做的事。
And another 3 years you will spend doing what you want to do.
如果你活了70岁，你曾经为人家服侍的时间总共大概有多少
？So I asked you, like, of the 70 years that you live, how many have you used to contribute for others?
大概只有3年。
Probably 3 years.
西安晚报有一个亲情的计算题，说如果你跟你的爸爸妈妈分隔2地，每一年你能回去几次？你真正的有多少时间可以跟你爸爸妈妈在一起
？So we have this math application question from this newspaper. I asked that if you live at a different place from your parents, how many times can you visit your parents? How much time do you really have with your parents?
他的问题，第二个问题说，如果你的爸爸妈妈再多活30岁，你大概还有多少时间可以跟他在一起
？So another question is that if your parents can live for another 30 years, how much time do you really have with your parents?
很多人来美国，假设1年只能回去一次，每次只有回去5天，再扣掉这些应酬、睡觉，就算爸爸妈妈能够再活30年，能够在他一起的时间大概只有1个月。
So if you return once annually, and then when you return, so let's say 5 days, and then you take out the time that you spent seeing your friends, eating, sleeping. Even if your parents can live for another 30 years, you probably have a month of time with them.
只有一个月.
Only 1 month.
所以圣经说，求主给我们懂得数算我们的日子，好叫我们得着智慧的心.
So our scripture teaches us to number our days so that we can gain a heart of wisdom.
很多爸爸妈妈都很注重教育，甚至才怀孕的时候就开始这个叫做零碎教育.
So a lot of parents that are so conscious about educating their kids, they start education since they were age zero, known as fetal education.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，胎儿在妈妈肚子里面的时候，当人还没有计划的时候，神已经有计划了。
So we know that even when you're just a fetus in your mom's womb, when people don't have plans for you yet, God already has a plan for you.
妈妈对孩子的影响大概是最深的。
So we think that a mother's influence on a person is probably the most influential.
James Fox 甚至这样讲，妈妈对孩子的影响，一辈子的影响无法估计。
So we have a quote from James Fox that says, the influence of the mother in the lives of her children is beyond calculation.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹,
brothers and sisters,
我想给大家来看诗篇这句话。
I want you to read this psalm from Psalm 127, verse 3.
请看得懂中文的一起念。来，儿女是耶和华所赐的产业。 所怀的胎是他所给的赏赐.
Let's read in English, please. English. Children are heritage from the Lord. Offspring are rewarded from Him.
妈妈是上帝交代最重要的任务的一个人.
Mother has a great mission from God.
因为神最看重的就是人。
Because God values humans.
甚至变成人的样式来到我们当中。
He even come in the form of a man to be with us.
神没有用其他的样式来到我们当中。
He has not used other images to come among us.
你就知道神对人有多看重。
So you know how much God values us.
每一个人在神的面前都非常高的价值。
Every person is a prized treasure in front of God.
然后他把这个事情交在妈妈的手。
And then he gives these people to the mother.
这是一个产业。
This is a heritage.
这是一个赏赐。
This is a reward.
可是妈妈并不是孩子的主人。
But the mother is not the master of the child.
换句话说，孩子并不是你的财产。
In other words, the child is not an asset of the mother.
妈妈其实是好的管家。
A mother is actually a good stewardess.
如果你有一个好妈妈,
if you have a good mother,
你真的很得到祝福。
You are so blessed.
如果你的太太又是好妈妈,
if your wife is also a good mother,
你的孩子得到很大的祝福。
Then your child is greatly blessed.
如果你的女儿又是好妈妈,
if your daughter also becomes a great mother,
你也要得到很大的祝福。
You will also have a good blessing.
你可以说阿们吗?
Can you say amen to that?
一个家庭当中，如果妈妈做了很好的一个角色，
so if a mother plays her role correctly in a family,
就可以使这个家庭当中许多人，每一个人，上帝的计划都要成全。
She can make all God's plans fulfilled on each and every one of the person in her family.
我来美国二十几年了。
I've been to America for over 20 years.
所以已经二十几年没有回去过母亲节了。
So it's been 20-something years I haven't gone back to spend Mother's Day with my mom.
所以我现在要跟妈妈说母亲节快乐，也都是打电话。
So when I say Happy Mother's Day to my mom, I always call her.
小时候我不太懂。
When I was little, I did not understand.
慢慢做了父母亲以后，比较明白。
After becoming a parent myself, I come to understand.
我常常在想，妈妈真是很不容易。
I often think it is so hard to be a mother.
因为妈妈常常是扮演付出、不断牺牲的那个人。
Because a mother constantly sacrifices, constantly gives.
当先生软弱生气的时候，当孩子软弱生气的时候，常常是妈妈接起来。
When the husband becomes weak and angry, when the child becomes weak and angry, the mother is the one there to give.
所以我觉得说，人家说母亲真的是上帝给的天使，每一个人的天使真的是这样子。
So someone said that a mother is like an angel given by God to everyone, and I believe so.
今天我一直祷告主啊，你要我讲什么题目呢？
So today I asked God, God, what do you want me to talk to my brothers and sisters about?
主感到我的心。
So God gave me this thought.
玛利亚。
Mary.
耶稣。是全世界最特别的一个人。
Jesus is the most extraordinary person in this world.
玛利亚一定非常特别，所以成为了耶稣的母亲。
Mary must be so special that she was chosen to be the mother of Jesus.
她有什么特别？
What is so special about Mary?
我希望今天在分享的时候，
I ask that today when you are sharing.
特别要给我们所有的人。
To share with everyone.
做妈妈的。
Our mothers.
或者是做儿女的。
Or our daughters.
做妈妈怎么样数算自己的日子，做一个神所交代的好母亲。
Like for our mothers, share like how you number your days, how do you use your days to fulfill God's plan.
我要讲到玛利亚人生当中七次很特别的遭遇。
So I want to share with you seven times.Special things that happened to Mary.
我们把我们想成，如果你是玛利亚，你会怎么样？
So put yourselves in Mary's shoes. If you were Mary, what would you do?
第一次。
First.
天使来到玛利亚的面前。
An angel came before Mary.
对他说：“你是蒙大恩典的女子，我向你请安，因为主与你同在。”
So Mary said that the angel said to Mary, "Greetings, you are highly favored."
如果你被拣选了做母亲，你有什么感受？
If you were the chosen one, the chosen mother, what would you do? What would you think?
很多姐妹发现自己怀孕的时候，哇，吓了一大跳。
Many sisters, when they discover that they're pregnant, they are surprised.
我竟然怀孕一个月，我不知道。
Wow, I've been pregnant for 1 month, I did not know.
有的妈妈怀孕很不容易，发现她怀孕了，她吓了一跳。
And a lot of mothers, they're not easily conceived, but when they are pregnant, they're surprised.
怀孕本身是一个非常特别的一个不寻常的遭遇。
So to have a baby is an unusual experience in itself.
如果你有机会成为人家的母亲，
if you have the chance to be someone's mother,
我看到玛利亚，她常常在想，这是什么意思？
When I see Mary, I always wonder, what does this mean?
这个妈妈会常常想，这是什么意思？
The mother would think, what does this all mean?
这是我觉得神拣选玛利亚的一个很重要的原因。
So I think this is a reason that why God picked Mary.
很多姐妹都计划好，第一胎什么时候生，第二胎什么时候生，第一胎要男的，第二胎要女的，都计划。
Many sisters are planning, okay, I'm going to have my first child this year and the second child the other year. I want my first child to be this gender, my second child to be that gender.
可是忘记了真正的生命是从神来的。
But often we forget that life really comes from God.
你是说阿妹吗？
You say amen.
当你怀孕做母亲的时候，
So when you're pregnant, become a mother.
实际上你不知道什么时候胎儿在你的肚子里面成型。
Don't really know when the fetus was conceived in your womb.
可是妈妈常常要想。
But the mother always thinks.
神让我怀孕是什么计划？
Now what is God's plan to plant this seed in my womb?
对这个孩子有什么计划？
Now what is God's plan for this child?
Amen. 非常重要。
This is very important.
妈妈不是小孩的主人。
Mother is not the master of the child.
很多小孩子很不快乐。
Many children are not happy.
是因为妈妈已经告诉他你要做什么，不要做什么，做什么，不要做什么。
Because they're not happy because they hear their moms like telling them you will be this, you won't be that, you will do this, you won't do that.
因为他想做的事跟他妈妈心里想他成为的人不一样。
Because what the child wants to be.And what the mom is different from what his mom wants.
最糟糕的是，上帝要使他成为的人，跟妈妈的想法不一样。
And becomes even worse when what God wants this person to become is different from what the mother wants this person to become.
所以这个孩子就不快乐。
So this child is not happy.
妈妈也不快乐。
And the mother is not happy.
你知道吗？当她怀孕的时候，天使说那个孩子的名字叫耶稣。
Do you know that when Mary was pregnant, the angel told Mary saying that this child will be named Jesus.
不但是男的，而且名字都有了，就叫耶稣。
So not even that she knows that that it is a he, and then the angel also told her what his name is to be.
而且说他要成为大卫王底下的国王，他的国永远不会穷尽。
And then the angel said that he is going to be great, and he is going to have the throne of his father David, and his kingdom will never end.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，
Brothers and sisters,
这不是只有发生在耶稣身上。
This not only happened to Jesus.
我们每一个人在妈妈肚子里面的时候，神就有计划了。
All of us have a plan for God.
你可以说 amen 吗？
Can you say amen to that?
我们每一个人在妈妈肚子里面的神就有计划了。
Every one of us, we already have a plan given to us when we're still in the womb.
只是没有人像天使这样可以跟我们讲得这么清楚而已。
Only that we don't have an angels proclaiming it as clear as they did for us.
可是这件事情很重要。
But this is very important.
妈妈要常常去想。
The mothers need to think.
神让我在这一年这个年纪做的妈妈，到底对这个孩子有什么计划
？That God, you made me become a mother this year. What do you have? What plan do you have for my child?
当时玛利亚还没有结婚啊。
And at that time, Mary was not married yet.
她说：“我怎么可以怀孕呢？”
Mary asked, "How can I be pregnant?"
这个成为我们的教会当中最宝贝的其中一个奥秘，叫做道成的肉身。
So this becomes a great mystery for our church, which is incarnation, Jesus fully becoming man and God.
到现在，人还是不能理解，怎么可能靠圣灵怀孕？
Even till this day, people cannot understand how can one person become pregnant from the Holy Spirit.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹
brothers and sisters,
耶稣同时是人
Jesus was man.
因为他从妈妈的肚子生出来
Because he was born through a mother.
可是他又是神
But he was also God.
因为他不是精子跟卵子生的
Because he was not born through a sperm and an egg.
所以耶稣就这么特别的来到我们的当中。
So Jesus came to us through this special channel.
我要说一句话。
I want to say this.
你我来到这个世界当中也是奥秘。
That you and I, when we came to this world, it's also a great mystery.
我们都是爸爸的精子跟妈妈的卵子生下来的。
We're all born through a sperm and an egg.
可是短短几个月在妈妈的肚子里面那个变化就是奥秘。
But just through those months,how we have evolved in our mom's womb is a mystery in itself.
Amen. 你跟旁边说，上帝创造你真奇妙。
Say the person next to you, you're amazing. Hallelujah.
上帝创造你真奇妙。
It's amazing that God created you.
你有没有想到，神只成为一个样式来到人间，就是像人一样
？Have you thought about that God coming to us in the form of flesh as humans?
神感动我，神来到人间不是其他任何的动物，就是像人一样。
And God really spoke to me and then gave me this amazing thought that God came not as other animals but as humans.
所以人啊，真的很特别啊。
So us humans are very special.
所以天使就告诉他说，你能够怀孕是因为圣灵降在你的身上。
So the angel told Mary that you are pregnant because the Holy Spirit came upon you.
你要生的孩子叫做神的儿子。
So the person you will give birth to will be called the Son of God.
我要再说一次。
I want to say it one more time.
每一个弟兄姐妹都是上帝的孩子。
That every one of us is a child of God.
Amen.都是从妈妈肚子里面生出来的
We are all born through our mothers.
都是上帝奇妙的创造的结果
We are all amazing creation of
Amen? 不要忘记了
Don't forget this.
所以玛利亚这么说
So Mary said,
我是上帝的使女
I am the Lord's servant.
情愿让这件事情发生在我的身上
May your word to me be fulfilled.
我看到它有两个很宝贝的地方
So I saw two very precious things.
第一个
First,
每次在人生当中发生什么事情的时候，他常常心里想，这是什么意思
that a lot of times when she has something unusual happen to her, she always thinks, what does this mean to me?
主啊，这是什么意思？
God, what does this mean?
为什么我遇到这件事？
Why am I experiencing this?
Amen? 你常常这样想的时候，
when you have this train of thought,
你就知道你不是主人。
You know, then you know that you are not the master.
你只是管家。
You are the steward or stewardess.
因为所有的一切生命时间都出自于神。
Because everything, every plan, every action comes from God.
太少的时候我们不问这个问题。
When we are little, we don't ask this.
所以从小孩子生下来，我就告诉他以后做什么，做什么，做什么，做什么，做什么，做什么，做什么，通通都决定好。
So when we have children, we tell everyone of our children that you will be this, you will be this, you will be this, you will be this, and we decide for them.
没有问神是这样吗？
We don't ask God, is this the right way?
这很可惜。
And this is unfortunate.
第二个好处是什么？
The second,
就是玛利亚常常会说，主啊，愿你的美好的旨意发生在我身上。
That Mary always says to God that may your wonderful will be fulfilled on me.
不知道神的旨意是什么，可是他很乐意说：“主啊，使用我。”
She does not know what God's will is for her, but she asks God, saying that God just use me.
我要送给所有的妈妈们，那以后要做妈妈的。
I want to give this to all our mothers and our expecting mothers.
第二个不寻常的遭遇。
The second unusual experience.
就是因为他还没有成婚，他就怀孕了。可是天使告诉他说：“以利沙白。”你的姑这个阿姨已经怀孕了，她已经不能生了，她已经怀孕六个月了。
So the second unusual experience is that when Mary was pregnant, she knew that her aunt Elizabeth was pregnant.
Angel told her.
Old angel told her.
所以呢，她知道她的这个阿姨早就不能过了生产的年龄了。
And she knew that her aunt is actually not the right age to give birth.
所以他听到他天使告诉他说，如果你的这个 aunt 都怀孕了，你要相信神可以让你怀孕。
So the angel said to her that if you know that the Lord made your aunt pregnant, then you know that the Lord can also make you pregnant.
所以当时候玛利亚就马上急忙的，天使告诉他就是赶快去找他的阿姨以利沙白。
So after she heard from this from the angel, so she hurried.To greet her aunt Elizabeth.
她一到房间就说：“伊丽莎白，伊丽莎白，你在哪里？我是玛利亚，我来看你了。”
So when she went to Elizabeth's house, she asked Elizabeth, "Where are you? I'm Mary. I'm here."
因为她很想告诉她说，天使告诉我这个奇妙的事情，我不知道是什么意思。
Because she wants to say to Elizabeth that angel told me this very unusual thing. I want to know what it means.
可是伊丽莎白一听到玛利亚问的时候，肚子里面怀的这个施洗约翰就开始跳动了。整个妈妈就被圣灵充满了，婴儿孩子也被圣灵充满了。
But we know that when Elizabeth heard Mary, then her child in her womb was just leaping with Holy Spirit.
所以当玛利亚还没有问任何事情的时候，伊丽莎白已经把答案都说出来了，说你真是在妇女当中最有福气的，你怀的他也是有福气的。
So before Mary even asked, Elizabeth already told her that.You are the most blessed among women, and then your child is the most blessed among men.
如果你是玛利亚，你会怎么样？
If you were Mary, what would you do?
哇，你说神真的是伟大。
Can you say that God is so great?
我还没有问，神就借着他告诉我答案。
That even before I asked, God already answered to me through that person.
甚至伊丽莎白最后一句话说：“相信的女子有福的。”因为主对他所说的话都要应验。
Elizabeth said, "Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord would fulfill His promise to her."
我看到玛利亚第三个很优秀的一个品格，就是我心尊主为大，我灵以我的主为乐。
And I saw the third great character of Mary. She said, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior."
她很喜悦神。他非常的尊荣他的神。
That she was very happy and very joyful to glorify the Lord.
妈妈们
，mothers，
如果你要成为一个快乐的母亲
，if you want to become a joyful mother，
最后你卸下了身体一切的重担，你可以快快乐乐的去见主的时候
that when you are able to, when you are at the age to shed this flesh and to see our God,
就是这样的心。
This is your heart.
主啊，我以你为喜乐。
And Lord, you are my joy.
主啊，愿你的一切美好的事情发生在我身上。
Lord, I ask all your wonderful will fulfill on me.
Amen. 后来那天晚上，她要生产的时候。
So at the night when Mary was about to give birth,
又遇到一个特别的遭遇。
There was another unusual experience.
一些牧羊人和博士匆匆忙忙的去找，看看那个婴孩在哪里。
So there were a bunch of shepherds who are looking for this child to see where the child is.
找到放在养牲畜的那个马槽里面去找 baby.
So they actually went to a manger to look for a baby.
一看到 baby 的就把他从天使告诉他们所有的话都告诉玛利亚。
So when they saw this baby, they told everything that the angel told them to Mary.
玛利亚刚刚才把 baby 生出来。
Mary just gave birth.
我有看过我两个小孩生出来的时候，我看到我太太那个脸非常生产很痛苦，生出来的时候真是喜乐。
And I remember that when I watched the birth of my own two daughters, when I saw my wife Melody's face, she was in so much pain, but after birth she was so joyful.
我觉得那个真是太伟大了。
I think that is such a great thing.
然后天使就所有的牧羊人就告诉玛利亚这个孩子的事情。
So all the shepherds told Mary about all these things.
然后玛利亚就把这个事情放在心里面，不断的思想，这是什么意思？
So Mary put all these things in her heart and she pondered over them.
所有的妈妈怀孕的时候，第一个愿望就是小孩子生下来的时候很顺利，很健康。
So many mothers, the first thing they hope, they wish for the child is for them to have their health.
然后再过几年要很聪明很优秀。
After a few years, they hope that the child will become smart. Become
然后过几年要赚很多钱。
After a few years, that they hope that their child will be very successful.
要求越来越大。
And so they have more and more expectations.
你有没有发现？
Do you notice this?
刚刚生下来只要健康喜乐就感谢主。
That right after birth, all they want for their children is for them to be happy and to be healthy.
哎呀，玛利亚就把所听到的这事情放在心里面。我很喜欢英文讲这句话 ，treasure up， 像宝藏一样不断的放在里面去思想，很宝贝的话。
So Mary treasured up all these things and pondered over them.
生了第八天，他们就照规矩到圣殿里面去行割礼。
So on the eighth day, according to their law, they circumcised their child.
就像美国的生产，第三天出院的时候，决定名字就要告诉医院是什么名字。
So it is like in our days today that when that after the third day of birth, the hospital wants you to give them the name.
玛利亚真的就把这个孩子叫做耶稣。
So Mary really called this.Oh, her son Jesus.
名字很重要的。
The name is important.
名字代表很多很多的期待在后面。
A name represents the expectation for this child.
这边让我看到玛利亚又一次的顺服。
So over here we see again Mary obeyed.
又一次的相信。
That again she believed.
然后第八天遇到第四次不平常、不寻常的遭遇。
And then we saw the fourth unusual experience.
当她跟她的先生走到圣殿去献婴孩的时候。
That when they were about to consecrate this child in the temple.
因为所有的男孩第八天要行割礼。
Because on the eighth day, all the children, all the male children need to be circumcised.
那这个充满圣灵的先知叫做西面。
So Simeon, who is a prophet, being filled with the Holy Spirit.
他被圣灵感动说去圣殿。
He was moved by the Spirit, and the Spirit told him to go to the temple.
将来的弥赛亚你要看见。
You will see the Messiah.
所以当他看到耶稣。从这个被玛利亚和约瑟带进来的那个时刻
，So at the moment that he saw Mary and Joseph bring Jesus，
他就把他抱起来了。
He held up Jesus。
他也没有问说这个孩子叫什么名字。
He didn't ask what is the name of this child。
他也没有说你叫什么名字。
He didn't ask what is your name。
他一看到说这个就是了。
He said this is the one。
哇，他甚至就讲说主啊，我可以闭上眼睛，你可以接我到天上了，因为我看见了你的救恩了。
And then he said, and he even said. said, Lord, you can dismiss your servant because I have seen your salvation.
如果你是玛利亚，你会怎么样？
If you're Mary, what would you do?
你会很惊讶的。
You would be surprised.
怎么一个老人突然就把我的孩子抱起来讲这样的话？
That this old man, this stranger, suddenly like held up my son and said these weird things.
说我的孩子是万民所预备的。
And to say that he was prepared for the Gentiles.
是外邦人的光。
The light of the Gentiles,
是以色列的荣耀
and the glory of the people of Israel.
所以约瑟跟玛利亚都很惊讶
So Joseph and Mary, they were all astonished.
最后西面讲完给孩子祝福以后就对妈妈说
So after Simeon blessed the child, Simeon said to Mary,
请注意特别为妈妈说对妈妈说
And I want you to pay attention especially to the mother.
这个孩子被设立
That this child is destined.
因为很多人会因他跌倒。
Because many will fall because of him.
很多人会被他兴起。
Many will rise because of him.
还会被人家毁谤。
And then he will also be slandered against.
我们知道后来耶稣长大的时候，很多人毁谤他。
And we know that there are a lot of slanders against Jesus.
很多人因为他所说的实话，不愿意顺服，跌倒了。
Many they were unwilling to listen to Jesus and fell.
很多人犯罪，可是因为悔改，反而兴起了。
Many sinned, but because of him, they rose.
很多人的心里想什么，被他显露出来了。
Many bad thoughts were revealed by him.
然后说你自己的心要被刀刺透。
And he even said to the mother that even your heart will be pierced by a sword.
这样的话。你生小孩第八天，不会有人对你这样讲。
Something like this, you won't hear on the eighth day that you gave birth.
我相信玛利亚一定听了非常的震撼，也牢牢记住。
I truly believe that Mary really treasured this up in her heart and remembered.
第五次的遭遇。
Fifth unusual experience.
每一年逾越节的时候，玛利亚跟约瑟都带着耶稣。到耶路撒冷去过节。
Every year Passover, Jesus' parents would bring him to celebrate Passover in Jerusalem.
因为所有的犹太人在逾越节其中一个日子要到耶路撒冷去过节。
Because many Israelites they would go back to Jerusalem on this day.
十二岁那一年的时候，耶稣跟去了。
When Jesus was 12, he followed.
因为十二岁是成年礼了。
Because 12 is like an adulthood for the Israelites.
犹太人的成年礼是十二岁就成年了。
So for the Israelites, they consider 12 a person of 12 to be an adult.
所以过节了以后呢，他们就跟着所有的群众都回家了。
So after the celebration, people were going back home.
哎，找不到耶稣。
They couldn't find Jesus.
然后就往回去找了。
So they went back.
过了三天才看见他，居然在圣殿里面没有走。
After 3 days, they found him in the temple court.
一直跟所有的那些老师在问问题。
Asking questions to the teacher.
然后呢，爸爸妈妈看着就很惊讶。
So the parents were astonished.
母亲玛利亚说：“儿子啊，你为什么这样对我们呢？”
And the mother Mary asked, "Son, why have you treated us like this?"
你难道不知道我们担心你吗
？Don't you know that we were worried about you?
你看我和你爸爸多担心，多伤心，找你找这么久。
Look at your father and look at me. We are so worried. We were.
耶稣说：“你为什么找我呢？”
Jesus asked, "Why were you looking for me?"
你难道不知道我应该关心我天父的事情吗
？Don't you know that I am in my father's house, caring for my father's matters?
你难道不知道我应该留在父亲的殿里吗
？Don't you know that I should be in my father's house?
这是第一次。
This was the first time.
耶稣对玛利亚说话。
Jesus said something to Mary.
你是我的管家。
You are my stewardess.
你是我在地上的母亲。
You are the mother in this world.
可是我很清楚我为什么来世界。
But I'm clear why I came here.
不是完成你的旨意。
Not to fulfill your will.
是我天父的心意。
But my father's will.
很多人听到这个教导吓了一跳。
Many are astonished when they hear this teaching.
说耶稣怎么那么没有礼貌啊
？Say that how dare Jesus.
爸爸妈妈找你找三天，你还这么没礼貌，讲这什么话
？The parents were looking for him for 3 days, and he was and he was being such and such a rebellious person.
可是你知道吗？玛利亚却把这样的话一直放在心里面。
But do you know Mary actually treasured this in her heart?
因为她一直在想，真的这是什么意思？
Because she really wants to know what does this mean.
因为她知道耶稣怎么来的。
Because she knows how Jesus came.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹
，Brothers and sisters，
如果你这样看你的孩子，你会很不一样。
That if you look at your children in this light, you will be different.
我想我们在成长过程当中，我们都问爸爸妈妈，我以后长大可不可以做这个，可不可以做那个。
I believe many of us, when we're growing up, we will ask our parents, "Can I be this? Can I be that when I grow up?"
我们的爸爸妈妈都会告诉我们，他喜欢我们做哪个，不喜欢我们做哪个。
Our parents will often tell us, "I really want you to be this. I really don't want you to be that."
可是有一件事情很重要。
But there's one thing that is very important.
你觉得上帝让你有这个孩子，是不是有他的特别的计划
？That do you believe God has a special plan for your child?
Amen. 你可以跟我这样重复的说吗
？Can you ask this question with me?
我相信。
I believe.
我相信。
I believe.
我的孩子。
My child.
神有计划。
God has a plan.
Amen. 你就会不会浪费很多的时间？跟你的孩子在浪费很多的时间在争，要做什么
？Because then you won't spend all this time arguing with your children about what they should or should not become.
你要常常带我们的孩子到神的面前，主啊，你在我生命的计划是什么
？That you need to bring your children before God and ask God, what is your plan?
今天我们很多新朋友。
We have a lot of new friends here today with us.
也许你从来没有听过这样的想法。
Maybe you've never heard of this teaching.
可是我要告诉你。
But I want to tell you.
如果你真的这样想。
If you think like this.
你跟你的孩子会经历到很不同的一个成长的过程。
You and your children will experience a different growth.
我很谢谢我的父亲。
I really thank my father.
因为我的父亲。他很尊重我。
Because my father respects me a lot.
我人生当中跳过好几次大的转变。
That I've turned my way so many times in my experience growing up.
每一次我都写信给我的父亲。
Many times I write to my father.
每一次我的父亲都回信。
Many times my father replies.
都会尊重我，然后问我说：“这是不是上帝要你做的？”
He will respect what I think and ask me.Do you think this is what God wants for you?
所以我每一次的转折的时候，我知道我的父亲是陪我一起走这段路。
So for every turn that I go through, I know that my father is there, my earthly father is there with me.
我想鼓励所有的弟兄姐妹，你的孩子也跟你一样这样子。
So I want to encourage brothers and sisters to really go through the same experience with your children.
等到耶稣三十岁的时候
，When Jesus was 30,
第六次的遭遇
，The sixth unusual experience，
约瑟可能死了
，Joseph was probably already passed at that time，
就是玛利亚可能守寡了
，So Mary was probably a single mom at that time。
约瑟什么时候死的时候，圣经没有讲
，The Bible does not mention when Joseph passed away。
可是耶稣可能也是做木匠，陪着妈妈，让他度过那个生活
，But Jesus probably。Followed his earthly father's footsteps to be a carpenter to help his mom with expenses.
玛利亚的先生过世了。
So Mary's husband is no longer.
他是不是更抓住他的儿子
？So Mary would cling on to her son.
不会这样。
Is that possible?
不想让他的儿子离开他。
That she doesn't want her son to leave her.
你知道有些妈妈在儿子结婚的时候。
You know that some mothers that when their son is getting married.
从来没有让他的儿子长大做人的丈夫，永远是他的儿子。
That they never let their sons be a man or be someone's husband, but always make them.
听得懂我的意思的请举手。
If you understand what I mean, raise your hand.
所以有的男人 人长到一个年纪就可以做爷爷了，还是儿子，从来没有做过爸爸。
So some men, like even when they're at the age of, when even when they're a grandparent, they still act like they're someone's son.
有些人就说怎么那么幼稚呢
？So sometimes you will ask, how is that person so childish?
因为他妈妈其实不希望他长大。
Because his mom doesn't want him to grow up.
为什么会这样呢
？Why would it be like this?
紧紧抓在身边。
Because they cling.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹
，Brothers and sisters.
耶稣有一天跟他。耶稣的妈妈玛利亚有一天跟她的兄弟来找耶稣，因为人很多，所以没有办法靠近耶稣。
So one day, his mother and brothers came to see him because there are so many people, they weren't able to come near him.
有人就说：“哎，耶稣啊，你妈妈和你的兄弟站在外面要叫你出去哎。”
So someone said, "Jesus, your mother and brothers are there calling for you."
耶稣回答了。
Jesus answered.
可能还是转个别人告诉他的母亲和兄弟。
And Jesus probably even like have someone like bring the message to his mother and.
所以也让现场的人都听见了。
And so probably everyone in the crowd heard it.
说听了上帝的话又去行的，就是我的母亲，就是我的兄弟了。
He said that those who hear God's word and put it into practice are my mother.
你说这是什么话？
How dare Jesus?
啊，所有人都变你妈了。
That everyone is your mother.
那你当我是什么啊
？Then who do you make me as?
很多妈妈孩子不长大也是讲这句话。
So a lot of mothers when they don't want their child to grow up is what they say.
我不是说妈妈不好。
I'm not saying that mothers are bad.
我是说妈妈如果没有常常回到我是上帝的管家，而是主人的时候，就常常告诉儿子这句话。
That what I'm saying is that when mothers are not aware that they are a stewardess and not a master, they would use this against their children.
他叫耶稣出来。
She asked Jesus to come.
因为人太多了，我进不去。
Because it's too crowded, I can't go in.
可是耶稣说，更重要的是，我要做神的心意。
But Jesus said, a more important thing is that I need to do the will of God.
很宝贵的是什么，你知道吗
？You know what is precious?
妈妈没有再叫人家送信回去。
That the mother Mary did not send it back.
去把那个不孝儿子给我叫出来。
To like ask that ungrateful son to come.
他居然敢这样子对我。
She did not say that. How dare him?
没有。
No.
玛利亚又想到一件事。
Mary thought about something else.
他正在做的事情，他讲的话是什么意思
？She was wondering what he does and what he says. What does it mean?
我看过妈妈在劝自己的儿子婚姻上面的时候，有时候不是帮忙，反而帮倒忙了。
So sometimes I hear mothers that say these encouraging things to their son.Their sons for their marriage, but then they're not really helpful things. Sometimes they're actually.
比如说，儿子跟他的太太吵架的时候，妈妈就说：“啊，他居然敢叫你做这些事，太可恶了！我也是妈妈，我从来不让儿子做这种事的。”
So, for example, like sometimes mothers when they hear the sons complaining about their wives, they would say, "What? How dare she? Like I'm a mother. I never asked you to do this. How dare she ask you to do this?"
妈妈要去想一件事。
Mothers, you need to think about this.
我儿子要长大，成为别人的丈夫。
That my son needs to grow up, become someone else's husband.
要成为别人的父亲。
Become someone else's father.
Amen.
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 这个如果想清楚
，If you are clear about this,
你的儿子会很谢谢你。
Your son will thank you.
Amen. 你没有太多反应。
It was not a very
第七次
，seventh time，
最激烈的一次
，the most emotionally eventful event。
玛利亚亲眼看到耶稣钉在十字架上。
Mary saw Jesus nailed on the cross。
知道他要完成天父的心意。
Knowing that he will complete God。
甚至必须死在十字架上。
Even to die on the cross.
圣经没有一次玛利亚去劝耶稣说：“你不要这样做。”
In the scripture, there is not once when Mary would ask Jesus, say, please don't do this.
我觉得玛利亚真的很不容易。
This is such a difficult thing for a mother.
因为当受钉十字架的时候，妈妈也在那里。
Because when Jesus was on the cross, his mother was right by him.
几年前有一部电影叫做 Passion of the Christ.
So a few years ago, there was this movie called Passion of the Christ.
那个导演很有想象力。
And the director has all these great imagination.
扮演妈妈的那个姐妹看到耶稣钉十字架的从头到尾是跪在地上，头都不敢看，因为实在是舍不得。
And I remember that in the movie, like the actress that portrays Mary, she was kneeling down and she didn't really want to look at Jesus when he was kneeling on the cross.
每一次有人鞭打他，钉子钉穿他的身体，大叫的时候，他就痛苦的用力抓着地上的石头。
That every time that someone laid a lash on Jesus, someone like pierced his body, Mary was just on the ground and really clenching on the rocks and really suffering.
那个痛苦的样子就好像很多妈妈在生产的时候很用力的抓着。
And then that image is just like those like mothers when they give birth and very very so much struggle and so much pain.
对不起，我又用我太太又做例子。
And I apologize to my wife because we use her as an example. Again.
她生产的时候抓我那个用力的力气，我从来不知道她力道有如此的大。
That when she was giving birth to my daughters, when she was clenching on my hand, I never knew she had so much strength.
我看到那个电影，那个妈妈每次一听到有人鞭打的时候，她就抓着地上的石头就跪在那里，头都不敢抬。
So I remember from the movie that every time someone was hitting Jesus, Mary was on the ground that she was just clutching on these rocks and she could barely like lift her head.
后来耶稣被钉在十字架上被举起来的时候，然后那个木头，因为那个十字架底下有一个圆圆的洞，所以就这样。就掉在那里面，把十字架立起来。
I remember, like finally, when they finished nailing Jesus on the cross, there was this hole on the ground, and then they lift up the cross, and finally the cross just landed in the hole and making a great sound.
然后妈妈头抬起来。
And Mary would lift up her head.
看到耶稣在十字架上。
See Jesus on the cross.
直到耶稣顺服到甚至死都还遵守神的旨意。
That she knew that Jesus like obeyed God and even died on the cross.
然后他手上的石头就慢慢松了，放掉。
Then her hand, her clenched fist, would finally soften, release the rocks in her hands.
我的儿子成全了天父的心意。
That my son has completed God's will.
放松了。
Then she was relieved.
那一刹那，我印象很深刻。
I remember this dearly.
所以后来耶稣告诉玛利亚这么说。
So Jesus told Mary.
妇人。
Say woman.
传统的原文不是写母亲，是妇人。
In the original scripture it says woman.
他告诉旁边的约翰，这是你的儿子。
He looked at John and said that this is your son.
告诉约翰说，看，这是你的母亲。
And said to John, look, this is your mother.
很多人看到这句话说，实在不能理解为什么耶稣要对他的母亲说妇人。
Many could not understand that why Jesus called his mother woman.
因为耶稣看到玛利亚，你真是了不起。
Because Jesus.Saw Mary and said, and then Jesus thought that you are so wonderful.
当你从我生下来一直看我在十字架上，你也成全神在你生命当中的计划。
That when you were obedient to give birth to me and to see me now on the cross, you are also completing God's will.
你不但帮助我成全神在我生命的计划。
Not only you help me fulfill my part in God's will,
而且你要成为祝福许多人的人。
You are also going to become a blessing for many other people.
从你到第八次的遭遇。
So lastly, the eighth time.
耶稣升天了。
Jesus ascended to heaven.
在死后四十天升天了。
After 40 days after his resurrection, he
was. 玛利亚也在那。
Mary was there also.
玛利亚从生了耶稣到最后死复活升天都在那里。
Mary was always there from the day that he was born until he ascended.
耶稣告诉他说不要离开耶路撒冷只等到天父要赐给你们的。
So Jesus told everyone, say, don't leave Jerusalem until my father gave you what he has promised.
你看到第一章十四节，所有的门徒还有耶稣的母亲玛利亚都没有离开，一起恒切的祷告。
So we can see that in verse 14 of Acts chapter 1, it says that everyone, including Mary, were praying in Jerusalem.
哇，我真是尊重玛利亚。
So I really respect Mary.
你看到了吗？
Do you see this?
她还是被人称呼耶稣的母亲玛利亚。
That she was honored being called Mary, the mother of Jesus.
她一生完成了神在她生命当中极大的计划。
That she completed her part in God's great plan.
我的爸爸妈妈年纪也大了。
My parents are also old.
我现在要看到他的时候，都要看到过 TV， 我看到爸爸头发都白白的。
Now, I actually see my father on television.
我尽量每一年回去看他。
That he has gray hair, and I always try to spend time to go see him.
这句话常常跑在我的心里面。
So I often am reminded of these words.
你母亲老了，不要藐视他。
That do not despise your father who is old.
不要轻视你的母亲，因为她老了。
Do not despise your mother when she is old.
妈妈老了，不能再生小孩了。
That mother is old and cannot give birth.
妈妈老了，舌头变味了，没有办法再煮好吃的菜。
The mother is old that she can't cook anymore.
妈妈之成为妈妈，并不是因为孩子的价值，是她本身就是上帝的儿女。
A mother is a mother not because of the child, but a mother is a mother is because of the plan of God.
很多妈妈忘记我是上帝的女儿。
That many mothers forget that they are the daughter of God.
她的孩子几乎变成她的上帝了。
And their children become their gods.
她的孩子要什么就给她。
That whatever children want, they give to the children.
等到孩子有一天长大离家了。
Only one day when the child leaves the house.
她突然发现我的价值在哪。
She suddenly asks, what is my value?
在这边我非常谢谢我的母亲。
So I want to really thank my own mother.
我母亲长大的过程很不容易。
But my mother did not have an easy life growing up.
这张相片是我爸爸1963年当兵的时候。
This picture is taken when my dad was serving the military.
这是我的表叔徐正峰。
So this is my uncle.
詹长老很熟悉。
Elder David is very familiar.
因为1963年的时候，詹长老跟我爸爸还有我的叔叔表叔都差不多同年龄了哈，一起在同一个教会长大。
Because back in the early 1920s, my Elder David actually grew up with my father and my uncle.
我爸爸在当兵。
So my father was serving in the military.
我的这个徐正峰牧师就是徐富珍的儿子。哦，对不起，就是我的这个叔叔也在当兵。
So my business uncle, he was also serving in the military.
因为当时的神学院政府没有这个承认，所以念完了一年神学院就去当兵了。
Because at the time the government did not recognize a seminary as a legitimate.Higher education. So after 1 year of being in seminary, they had to serve in the military.
我爸爸和我的这个表叔，他们都在想，当完兵之后，还会不会再继续去做念神学院，去做牧师？
So at that time, my father and my uncle, they were wondering that after they finished their obligation, they were going to return to seminary to complete their education.
因为做牧师需要上帝的呼召， Amen.
Because to be a pastor, you need a calling.
我相信从来没有一个这个专业和职业或者是工作像牧师这么好的。
I believe that there's no other profession that is so wonderful like being a pastor.
人家花钱请你念圣经。
That other people will pay you to read the Bible. Do you understand?
很多人以为做牧师很不好，很辛苦。
So many think that, oh, being a pastor is such an awful job.
我真的觉得做牧师是上帝一个很大的恩典。
But I really appreciate the fact that being a pastor is really a great blessing, a great gift from God.
可是很不容易。
It is not easy.
这是我2007年我们家的全家福。
This is a picture of my entire family in 2007.
我有两个弟弟。
I have two younger brothers.
我们三个人从来没有想到长大会做牧师。
All three of us did not think that we would become pastors.
没有想到我们通通做牧师。
That we cannot fathom that we all three of us became pastors.
有人打电话来家就说彭牧师在不在家？
When someone calls to my house and says, "Is Pastor Peng home?"
他们就说是哪一个？
Then the person on the phone was,
是老的呢？
Have to reply,
还是大中小？是哪一号？
Which one? Old one or the big one, middle one or young one?
最中间这个是我小弟的最小的儿子。
So in this picture, this is the youngest son of my youngest brother.
很奇怪，我在放这个相片的时候，我突然感觉有一天他也要做牧师了。
So it's weird because when I put this picture here, that I think that, oh, maybe one day he will become a pastor too.
在这边愿主祝福天下的父母亲。
So I ask God to bless all the fathers and mothers in this world.
尤其是像周牧师、詹长老，我们当中年长的我们的弟兄，罗伯伯、陈伯伯，我们会请这个60岁以上的长辈，请你站起来一下，好吗？弟兄姊妹，好吗？60岁以上，请你站起来。
For over 60, if you stand. For over 60, for over 60, I ask you.
哇，我们新朋友建筑啊，今天请他搬椅子，真不好意思。我们再一次拍手。很高兴他的到来，很高兴。不错。在教会里面有一个非常好的事情。
So there's one wonderful thing in church.
要尊重我们的长辈。
It is the respect we have for our elders.
Amen. 我们当中有老有少。
We have older ones, we have younger ones.
是很得祝福。
So we are very blessed.
好啊，时间已经到了。
So now it is time.
第二12:30。
Now it's 12:30.
我想请我们的弟兄们。
I want to ask our brothers.
60岁以下。
Under 60.
在外面赶快预备。
To go out and help prepare.
好不好？这时候我们请一起站起来，我们来为了今天最后的祝祷，那奉献来祷告。
So let's do our final prayer and benediction.
你可不可以花时间先求主祝福你的母亲，好不好？
So I want to ask you to spend some time to ask God to bless your mother.
不管你的母亲是不是还健在。
No matter if your mother is still here in this world.
我们祷告祝福我们的母亲。
Let's pray and bless our mother.
特别祝福我们的妈妈们。
Yeah, I want to ask you to bless my mother's
身体健康，心里常常有神的喜乐，给我们的妈妈和姐妹们，作为属灵的母亲，祝福我们的下一代，常常问主耶稣说，主啊，这是什么意思？常常说，主啊，愿你的美好的旨意行在我的身上。愿圣灵大大恩待我们每一个人，纪念每一个母亲的心啊，孝顺父母的人在世要长寿，这是神给我们的第一条诫命，当孝敬你的父母，奉主耶稣的名所求。
Amen.
大家平安，母亲节快乐。